Alright, this time we're having a little bushcraft battle, and just to make it fair, so I know there's no funny business, we're going to sharpen both of them. We've got the Mora Bushcraft in tan, which is what I'm sharpening now on my Lansky. I'm doing this at 20 degrees. We're suffering technical difficulties, and this is the third shoot I'm doing. Need some more. I want to point out I'm not good at sharpening. Okay, there. Next up, we're going to sharpen the Finhawk. Yeah, this is the Cold Steel Finhawk. And I'm making sure they're both nice and sharp to keep a fair competition. I'm running a fair competition here. No cheating, no phony business, no nothing. No foul play. Just trying to get them both to the same level of sharpness. Definitely can shave. Yep. I think we're ready to start with the bushcrafting tasks. We just load up the Lansky. That's what we're using. That Lansky fits right and snugly in the pocket. Not bad at all. Yeah, baby. Nice. So that was the Mora Bushcraft. Hot out, sorry. Whoa, wrong spot to put that. Now for the Finhawk. I wonder if it's the angle, because I'm honestly more likely to blame myself for that. Let me try the other side, actually, because this side seems a bit more rotted than the other. So let me try this out. Ooh. It's a bit better. Probably should have dropped these first. This is making wider but thinner ones, honestly. So we're gonna give that a go. I'll tell you what, ever since I modified this spine, well, still. You know, I think I'm gonna try again. Okay, we got the same kind of wood. This is actually the other half of the piece I was using for the bushcrafter. Yeah, this isn't feather sticking as good as the bushcrafter. The bushcraft, I mean. But let's give it a try. Let me try something out. Let me get a different piece. Oh, okay, there. I stamped it out, don't worry. There we go. I was wrong. We'll do that with the bushcrafter too. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. All right, I'm gonna work with that same piece with the bushcraft, with a more bushcraft. Keep it fair. Had a large ant crawling on me. Don't like that. I wonder if I'm dulling the edge by accident. So it definitely is working. I wonder. Alright, we're gonna try this again. This time we're gonna use a little fat wood, but we're also gonna do some more carving. I'm gonna show something. That this knife can split this. There we go. Alright, wow. That's pretty good. Oh, I'll put that back in my pocket. Yeah, it might be wet. I wanted to see if I could do it without the fat wood, but it doesn't look like it. So... Oh, shoot. I didn't get you in. I didn't get that in the shot. Sorry. What's nice about fat wood is you don't have to have your fingers right near it. Watch this. Do that from a bit of a distance. I don't know how far that would work. Should we find out? Maybe we will after we do the same test with the fin hawk. That away from the rest of the wood. And where's that piece? I'm gonna split it down again. Not bad. Almost. Yeah, let's just make life a little easier. I don't know if I mentioned it already, but this fin hawk has a modified spine. It's not a perfect 90 degree like it says, like a lot of people say it is. It ain't. Let me just clean it off a little. Up. Completely missed the fat wood on that one. Let me just get it over. Not bad. Next, I think, but first I'm going to go over the sheets, after I clean off this knife. Both have this durable plastic sheath. The Mora's wins though, because it's got a little sharpener and a ferrule and a fire steel holder. Now, I want to see just how far I can go with the fat wood so it'll work. And I've got two of them here. dry from here. This is about 5 feet. I'm almost getting it. I'm gonna try it at one step closer. Almost that time. Up. Getting there. You know, screw it. Here we go. Uh-oh. There's a crack in my iPad. That's fine, it's fine. It shouldn't be too bad. It's not too bad. Anyway, I think I'm gonna do some more feathers with the bushcraft. Can you tell this was my this one's my favorite bushcraft knife? I wonder if that's too wet. I wonder how that crack got on my iPad. If you know any way to fix that crack, home remedy, I appreciate it. I don't want to mess it up. But I think that's... Once that gets up to speed, I think that might be how we close the video. Let me just get some fat wood off. This is the store-bought fat wood. Once this works, I don't want to close out this video on a failure. I want to leave with success. There we go. So anyway, hope you enjoyed. Links are going to be in the description down below. Thanks for watching.